Mele, Kunjani, Goeiemôre. I hope everybody's well. God has inspired us to give short messages of encouragement to everybody. And God speaks to us in many ways. God speaks to me through music. And I love all forms of music. I love classic rock, the blues, jazz, the 60s, gospel music, and even township music, Yuma Sikela. But and this morning I went walking, and I was speaking to God, and I was speaking to God particularly about the video that's doing its rounds in where is God in all of this? Where are you, God, in all of this? And God answered me. And he answered me through a song, because the song by Police, Every Breath You Take. Yeah? And I'll sing a bit. Every breath you take, and every move you make, I'll be watching you. Oh, can't you see? You belong to me. All right. Okay. That sounded a bit false, but, you know, God is watching over us. He's watching over us. Every breath we take, every move we make, I'll be watching you. So he's watching us. I'll go to Genesis 28. It says there, from verse 15, what's more, I am with you, and I'll protect you wherever you go. One day I'll bring you back to this land. I'll not leave you until I've finished giving you everything I promised you. He'll take us through all of this. I'll take you back to what I promised you. Psalms 100. Verse 3. Acknowledge that the Lord is God. He made us and we are His. We are His people, sheep of His pastures. We belong to Him. Now, I believe that there are two types of people. Regardless of race, regardless of color, regardless of gender, you either believe or you don't believe. You're either with God or you're without God. And God answered me in another way. And he said, where are you in all of this? Don't ask me where I'm on all of this. I'm asking you, where are you in all of this? Now, we all know the story of Job, and for those that don't know the story of Job, is that Job, God counted Job as a righteous man, and he was rich beyond comparison, and the devil approached God. Yes, the devil does approach God, and said to him, but Job is righteous because he's got everything. He's got everything he needs. And God said to him, oh, well, in that case, test him, try him, and see whether he's still righteous. So the devil went and took everything from him. And he lost everything. He went through pain and suffering and diseases and all sorts of things. And he did question God at some stage, but three of his friends even questioned God. I'll go to Job 28. Where the Lord challenged God, Job. And it says it from verse 2, who is that that questions my wisdom with such ignorant words? Brace yourself like a man, because I have some questions for you. Where were you when I laid the foundations of the earth? Tell me if you know so much. Right through to chapter 40. Then the Lord said to Job, do you still want to argue with the Almighty? You are God's critic, but do you have the answers? Do we have the answers? No. Right? Challenged him. So God said to me, where are you in all of this? Where are we in all of this? Do we have the answers? Do you have the answers? No. I mean, we haven't even got the cure for the common cold. They might cancer. So, in through all of this, God is watching us. Every breath you take, every move you make. Now, when I went to that phrase that I believe that there are two types of people in this world. You either believe or don't believe. And I've got a challenge for the unbelievers. And I suppose believers as well. But go on your hands and knees during this period. Go on your hands and knees. What have you got to lose? But what did you lose? Go on your hands and knees and ask God, where is he in all of this? Ask him. And don't be surprised when he answers you back and says, where were you? Where are you in all of this? Huh? And even if you still don't believe at that stage that he's with us, and this is all finished, this you know, the final countdown, wow. Another word for another time, but we're in the final countdown. And this is all finished. And we found the cure for COVID-19, and the economy has returned back to normal, and life has returned back to normal, and we're all living now our comfortable, cushy lives again. Are we going to go on our hands and knees, and are we going to thank God that he brought us through all of this? He took us through the storm, a year of little faith. Okay? Are we going to thank him? Try it again. Thank him and see what effect it will have in your life. And even, I've got even more news for you. More news for the unbelievers. Even then, if you still don't believe, and you still continue not believing, God still loves you, my man. God still loves you, regardless. He loved us long before we loved him. I mean, it says that, and it all describes it in Romans 8, and I'm going to go there, from verse 38. It says there, and I am convinced that nothing can separate us from God's love, neither death nor life, neither angels nor demons, neither our fears for today nor our worries about tomorrow. Not even the powers of hell can separate us from God's love. Not even the powers of hell can separate us from God's love. No power in the sky or on the earth below. Indeed, nothing. Zara, nulch, chai, in all creation, will be able to separate us from the love of God that is revealed in Jesus Christ our Lord. That is revealed in Jesus Christ our Lord. God died, Jesus died for you, people. Jesus died for you. Even if you don't believe, even if you don't, he died for you. For all of us. Wow. Ain't that a thing? Huh? So, I'm going to leave you with that word. And I'm going to leave you also with a song. Oh, can't you see? You belong to me. And I'm going to now pray. And just give me a chance here. And let me just get on my hands and my knees. And I'm going to pray for all of you out there. Father, we thank you. We thank you for everything you've done in our lives, Lord. We thank you that you loved us long before we loved you. Father, we pray that you'll bring us joy and peace. Let the peace, your peace, rule in our hearts. And Father, we thank you for the strength and the courage that you've given us throughout this period. Because we know, Father, that nothing is impossible for you. And nothing can separate your love for us. For thine is the power, the kingdom and the glory, forever and ever. And we cry out, Abba, Father, that thy will be done. Amen. Bless you all. Till we meet again.